think it's kind of something that happens both ways. Like, I'll practice for myself for outside factors. For example, if there's a concert or something like that, I want to sound good for me. So I practice my part for the concert so that I can sound good, but also so that the concert sounds good as a whole and the audience enjoys it.
I'd say more for myself. Just getting common stuff out of the way, you know, bettering myself, I guess.
I found myself practicing for a little both, like, I just don't want to be embarrassed by what if I go up to play. I mean, some instructors just expect you to do well, and some are just saying, like, good job today or something like that. So, sometimes yes, sometimes no.
Yeah, I guess so. I'd say that I am. I'm more playing for me. I'd like it if everyone else enjoyed it, but mostly I'm playing for me. If I sound good, I want to practice more, because I want to make myself sound even better. And if I don't sound good, I want to practice more, because I want to make myself sound better. So.
My teacher, he's very supportive. Boris Kucharski, he's the man.
Okay.
And when you practice enough, you get something right. You know, especially working on the solos. You know, usually you kind of get like practice room high after a couple hours, mm-hmm. just going at it. And if you get something down, then you just get in the groove and you just go. It's pretty cool.
Yes, I do. My teacher tells me I do well. If I do well, my teacher tells me if I'm not doing well, if I don't do well. So I get reprimanded and rewarded. Reprimanded, I put in more hours and I practice much harder. And when I do get rewarded, I practice that much harder because I have to top off the last lesson. I do set goals for my practice sessions, and what goal I set depends on what I need to learn and work on. For instance, sometimes I'll be working on two measures of a certain piece, and I can spend an entire hour just perfecting jumps from chord to chord over an hour on just two measures.
If I'm having trouble at a certain part in the music, what I'll do is I'll bracket it off, and then I'll sometimes pull it out and say, okay, I need to work on this, and then I'll usually have it set so that by the time I'm practicing, that'll be done.
I try to. A lot of times I get sidetracked.
Oh, yeah?
I just practice other things I don't want to practice as opposed to things I have to practice.
Because I play for me, a lot of my consequences are mostly me. I don't like me for a little while. I get angry at me in the same way I get angry at a student of mine for not doing well.
Not necessarily consequences, it's just I don't feel good when I don't play well.
If I don't play well because I overplayed, I will take a day off. But if I just don't play well, I will be in a bad mood.
I'll play something over and over and over again until I get it right. But then there's times where I'll play it over and over and over again, and it won't get better. I'll be like, yeah, I'll be fine. I'll do it tomorrow. So I'll set it aside.
It depends on the mistake that I make. If it's a mistake like a note slip and something that I know I usually get right, I'll carry on. If it's something that I know is becoming a problem, I'll stop and fix it. ¶¶
pretty impossible not to. I'd say that my musical knowledge lends itself to other things that I do, like my practice habits and my knowledge of how to make things work by practicing. Lend itself to other things, and I think that other things also lend themselves a lot to music. Like knowing how you are as a person affects how you practice. So if you know that you're the kind of person who doesn't who procrastinates a lot, you're going to be procrastinating while you're practicing too. So you have to sort of bring that in there. And so whatever you are as a person lends itself to music, and whatever you are musically lends itself to you as a person.
Here's a little song I wrote.